Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of City Skylines. Now, this episode, I'm sure you've noticed, is going to be quite a bit shorter than what I normally put out. The reason for that is I spent some time over the past couple of days looking through the analytics on my YouTube channel and noticed that the average watch time of my videos is roughly about 5 minutes. So out of a 30 to 40 minute video, most people are watching on average, I'd say between 5 minutes and 15 minutes. So with that being said, I figured it would be a good idea to start keeping these videos to a shorter length. That way people are more, I guess, enticed to watch them. Because there's really no point in making a half-hour video if most people are going to skip through or if they're just going to watch, 5 to 10 minutes of it. So why not just make a, 8 to 10 minute video and they will hopefully watch the whole thing. Anyway, to the build here. So what I'm doing is I'm actually starting the framework here for a military base. Now, I know I said in the previous episode that I was going to do a pier and a sports stadium and some other things like that. But when I got to messing around with it and trying to figure out how to do that or how I wanted it to work, I just wasn't quite feeling it. And then I started looking at some of these assets I had for the military base and the spot I was in here, and I was like, you know what? This is going to work wonderfully. So I decided to go ahead and continue on with that. Now, there's still plans to do a sports arena and a pier later on, just probably not right now, so I apologize for that. So what I'm doing here at the entrance to the military base, that's what this is. This is a build for the entrance to the military base. As you can see, we just finished up the entryway, the gate there, and then I put down that jet on a pillar, which I thought turned out pretty cool. It's like if you go to like an Air Force base or a military base, a lot of times they'll have a jet like that up on a stand by the entrance, and I thought that was a cool little thing to add, so I was happy I was able to make that work there. And then right here off to the side, this is a little side road where if, let's say a delivery or something was coming onto the base, they would direct it off to the side around here into this hangar area, into this little area for inspection. So that's what this little hangar thing is here, and I thought it looked pretty cool there off to the side. And then what I'm doing here is, let's see, I think I add a wall. I have these cool walls. These are the ones that I was going to use later on for an embassy in the downtown area also. But they turned out to be pretty awesome looking for the perimeter for the base as well, so I decided to use them here. And there's two different types of walls. They have the walls that are just the props like this one, and then they also have the walls that are like buildings. You put them next to the roadside, so you can have them perfectly aligned as well. For these, I just use the props. That way I can make them conform to the shape that I want them to. And maybe later on when I do the downtown build, because that'll be, in perfect blocks, I'll use the actual building ones. So it'll look pretty cool that way. Then right here for the airplane, or for the jet display, I decided to go with a brick wall behind it as kind of like a barrier between the concrete and the grass. And you'll see it here in just a moment. I think it turned out pretty cool. I like the way it ended up looking after it's all completed. Now, I did want to take a moment and kind of talk a little bit about what's going on with this build and some other stuff. I know I've touched on this before in some other episodes of City Skylines, but I've been thinking a lot about my channel and what I want to do with it, and while I love playing City Skylines, you'll notice that I have branched off to a few other games. You're going to start seeing a lot more of that. Now, I am still going to put out Cities videos quite regularly, But I would like to put some other content on here as well, just because I like playing a variety of games. And the City Skylines community is phenomenal. You know, I love everybody that plays it. I like, you know, spending a lot of time on Reddit looking at all of people's creations and stuff. But it's just such a small community. And I really want to expand the channel into different types of games, with hopes of maybe people watching these videos as well as the other ones, and to maybe get more people into this game as well as other games as well. So you'll start seeing some more uploads on my channel of other games also. So if you're just here for City Skylines, don't worry, it's not going anywhere, but you'll start seeing other games popping up as well. I've been playing a little bit of Star Trek Online that you've seen. You might see some American Truck Simulator coming up, because I love ATS. I've had it for quite some time, and I might do a playthrough on of that. Not really a playthrough, but I might do like a career mode on there and have some of those videos uploaded as well. So just be on the lookout for that if that's something you're interested in. If not, you know, I'll still have regular uploads of City Skylines, so you can definitely keep an eye out for that as well. So back to what I'm doing here. I decided to put another little half wall right here in front of the jet as kind of like a barrier of sorts. With there's going to be these little signs next to it that will kind of display some information about the plane. Or maybe it can serve the purpose of some sort of memorial or something like that. I'm not quite sure. I don't have a real story behind it at this point. But I really enjoy the way that it turned out, and I'd have to say I'm happy with it. So that actually pretty much wraps it up for this episode. So we're going to go ahead and end it here. And I thank you guys so much for watching, and I do hope you have a great day.